Today we look at some more photos and one more video on this bitter gourd. Now, since the last almost 2 years, I have been working on these bitter gourds, and we got all kind of varieties. And I found now that 3-4 distinct types are emerging. One is that dwarf tiny variety. Another one is long and very bitter and light green. And one more is somewhat medium bitter and dark green, looks very nice. And then this is the fourth variety that has come. Here the ridges and all are not very sharp and pronounced like the other three varieties. It's more rounded. And I don't know how the seed has come. Either it is genetically it is now surfacing, or some seed has come in. Anyway, that's a shot of that bitter gourd. Now, I'm growing this in a pot. Now that this bitter gourd I have grown in my perma pot. There is already one video made on this perma pot. We grow garlic and onion last year. It's there in this video series. Now, this is the perma pot. It's basically an old plastic drum that's been cut off, and then that bitter gourd started its life here. See there, and then it has climbed on to the lemon tree there, and I have added fresh vermicompost and manure, because otherwise the fruits will be very tiny, in number will be less, and then I cover it with a layer of Lagerstamia dry leaves, so that it is the whole day it has to be moist, because in the pot the loss of moisture is high, roots also can't spread much, so it becomes over dependent on human interference. I'm watering twice a day and cover this these dry leaves, and then over that this colocasia leaf is closed so that it retains the moisture nicely throughout the pot day. Like this, close. And then otherwise it has all the features of the regular bitter gourd, except the shape is little different. And as usual, they are very clever in hiding, these bitter gourds. So whatever we do, one or two will escape notice and ripen up. And since I've been growing now for last 2 years, quite a few unharvested fruits were there. And it has ripened on the plant, and then the birds have dispersed it. Nowadays I find that it has become naturalized in the garden. And it's become like a weed. It started growing on its own. Here and there you find them sprouting new plants. And probably these will have the highest vigor and surviving energy, because they're on their own. Almost adjusting to the seasons. And here at the base of this lemon plant there is one little bitter gourd baby has just sprouted. It has come on its own. The birds have dropped the seed and it has sprouted. So I'll allow it, I'll water it and climb it onto this citrus plant, so both can get the water. I'll get a crop of citrus and some bitter gourd. That's the perma pot bitter gourd story.